Good evening from the Truss Arena in Henderson, Auckland, New Zealand. It's match day three of the OFC President's Cup, and it's the second game of today, pitting Buzaitin of Bahrain, the former Premier League and Cup holders, against FIFA Under 20 World Cup bound Fiji Under 20. I'm Gordon Watson. I'll be describing tonight's match for you alongside my colleague Indra Singh. Indra, welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much, Gordon. Good to be back in the chair after the historic event in May in Suva. But what another outing coming up for the under-20s, in particular playing against a team like Buzaitin, laced with professional players, Gordon.
Well, look, it's a marvellous opportunity for Fiji Under 20 and the young players to get some experience and to learn from the best.
Yeah, and I think that's the point of this tournament for these young players, is that they play against the best. They've played against Amical, now they come up against Buzaitin, so definitely something to take under the belt heading into the World Cup in about 6 months' time here in New Zealand.
Well, they do have their work cut out, Fiji Under 20. They're playing against a team that, as Indra said, is laced with professional players. These players have, for the most part, been six or seven games into their domestic season already, and they are struggling in the Bahraini Premier League, it has to be said. They're in the bottom three or four of that division. They have a squad of over 53 professional players. The referees for tonight's match are led by New Zealand's Nick Waldron, Terry Piri of the Cook Islands, Folio Moiaki of Tonga, and Albert Maru of Papua New Guinea make up your quartet. So, Indra, when you're putting a young team out against seasoned professionals, you really have to have your expectations measured, I think.
Yeah, definitely. Looking at the first game itself, as we watch the upcoming matches, the fifth and sixth place playoff on Sunday here at the Truss Arena, and then the third and fourth playoff and the final, the grand final, that's already been decided. Auckland City versus Amical. Everyone's looking forward to that one. But coming back to this, the young under 20 team, this is what they need. As we see the points table, Auckland City on top after the massive beating of Bowden Town, 9-0 on 6 points, and Singapore on the 23 second, Bowden at the bottom of the ladder.
So here's the Buzaitin lineup. No changes for coach Khalifa Al Ziyani. He's stuck by the men who were beaten by Amical. No changes to the formation either. It's a straightforward 4-4-2 formation with Eliel De Cruz at the top of that. For Fiji Under 20, well, Indra, talk us through these changes that have been made.
Yeah, coach Ravnesh Kumar has brought in the goalkeeper Divikesh Dale, who plays his trade here in New Zealand. Also brought in Shoaib Khan from the Waitakere City, and Gabrielli up front, and Tevita Warinivalu, 3-5-2 formation for the Fiji Under 20s.
So the pre-match formalities still underway. And one of the characteristics of the match between Amical and Buzaitin was just that opening period where Buzaitin threw everything at Amical, and I sat here thinking that perhaps it was going to be a rout, but Amical just were able to survive that difficult moment and then come into the game, and we saw Fiji do the same in their match with Amical.
Yeah, definitely. What a start Fiji had in that game. There's still talks about those missed opportunities in front of goal, but that's how the strikers learn. They'll be up against the big boys at the World Cup, players who've already played and tasted professional football. It's a grand opportunity for these under-20s, just talking on the Fijian perspective, Gordon, that they are getting this outing. What a concept, the President's Cup, and they get to come up against the big boys. And nothing to be taken away from them. They need to learn, and talking to the coaching staff, it's all about getting that experience under the belt and heading to New Zealand next year for the FIFA Under-20 World Cup.
Well, let's not mince our words. Fiji Under 20 are going to come up against teams that aren't too far off the calibre of Buzaitin and Amical. They are in many respects a finished product, particularly when you take into account the likes of Lionel Messi, who played in 2005 at the Under 20 World Cup in the Netherlands, and Sergio Aguero in 2007 in Canada. This is not a nursery. The Under 20 World Cup, you come up against players that have up to a season and a half of full-time professional football under their belt in the likes of South America and Europe. And Fiji Under 20 are coming out of Fijian, New Zealand domestic football and having to find that level and find it quickly. So Gabrielli will get this game underway for us with Solawanga up front. Warren Availu. Fiji go long into Wanga. Picked up by Rao. Nyam. Mohamed Sultan. Here is Eliel de Cruz.
Yeah, the changes made. Gabriel Imatanisinga up front. He wasn't part of that squad in May in Fiji when they qualified for the World Cup. Bought in to replace the injured Samuel Anambenya, who got injured in a local match back at home.
Pranil Naidu. Deflection falls kindly for Fiji. They can clear their lines here. They've done so. And Giuliano De Paola concedes the foul on Solawanga. De Paola has distinguished himself in Bahraini football, but also in Brazilian football, of course. Here's Hughes. This is a good run, and De Paola has to put his boot through it to clear the danger. Encouraging start for Fiji under 20s.
A similar start to what they did against Amical the other night.
And I think, Andrew, they just have to try and make those periods of play last longer. As Nyam goes toe-to-toe with Savoki. Throw taken quickly for De Cruz. Alajmi. Now De Paola. Played straight into the feet of Ajaj, who's given it away straight away. Here's Prasad. Now Naidu. Well, just panicked a little, Pranil Naidu. Badesh. Mohamed Sultan. Can't keep that in. It's a throw for Fiji.
Some big boys in this Busaitin team here this evening. And this is another test for the Fijian players, the physicality of these professional teams.
Well, this has happened right in front of us. I didn't see any contact. Mm. But the player's face, it's Mohamed Sultan. Now, they've both got a hold of each other here. Was it the trailing left arm? I don't think it was as serious as is being made out. Naidu. One characteristic about Busaitin that was clear from minute 1 to minute 90 is that when Amaker were looking to play the ball anywhere along the back or to the goalkeeper, Busaitin pressed aggressively up the pitch. They didn't give Amical any time to settle on the ball at any point whatsoever. Savoki. Al-Khalaf. De Cruz. One thing's for sure, Busaitin will be eyeing this game for maximum points. They're reputation has already been shaken somewhat after losing to Amical. This is good from Fiji. Hughes, Wanga, Naidu.
Got it. As you mentioned, it's upon maintaining it from the minute 1 to minute 90. And can the Fijians do that? That'll be the question. That's what's been drilled into them earlier on after that loss against Amical. You got to play this game right throughout the 90. But again, it's a learning curve, and this is where they'll get better and better.
Encouraging first 5 minutes for Fiji. This is broken kindly for Gabrielli. He's hooked it back in, and Haram has had to punch it with one hand. Now, Pranil Naidu has it. Works a ball into the far post. It's a good one. And Haram spectacularly, somewhat unnecessarily, saves it. But this is looking good for Fiji.
They were watching the Amical and Busaitin game the other night, picking up the way Amical put Busaitin under pressure. Trying to duplicate that here.
Naidu. Now this is where Busaitin have been more than happy to push on to teams high up the park. That's a good clearance from Deo. Kusi. Al-Khalaf. Mohammed. Oh, Al-Khalaf's given that away. Warren Navailu opens play up through Naidu. Tuivuna. Rao for Savoki. Well, Fiji haven't taken a step back. They're not showing Busaitin too much respect. Just a little shove in the back, conceding the free kick.
Another test will be for Divikesh Deo. He didn't play a single game at the qualifiers. He wasn't in the squad. He was brought in from New Zealand, but wasn't in the part of the final squad.
De Paula. Abdullah Badesh. Ajaj. And Matana Singer is pulled up for a handball. Well, Setariki Hughes has been deployed in a midfield position tonight, Indra.
Yeah, he has been, and that was the team tactics because the regular skipper, Charlie Dreloa, is out after copying that injury against Amical. He's been rested. Setariki, who plays in the midfield for his club side, Rewa, in the Fijian League.
Here's Hughes. Well, this is what Busaitin do best. Is shut down space. They're right in your face. From the word go.
I think Busaitin a bit shell-shocked maybe, expecting to have an early run against the Fijians, but the Fijians are keeping that momentum, what they showed against Amical in the early stages.
Well, Busaitin have actually got the hardest fixture list when you look at it. They didn't start until Wednesday. This is their second game in a 48-hour period, and of course the finals loom on Sunday. Oh, that's well played by Wanga. Al-Khalaf goes in hard. Ajami has come clear with it. A chance to counter-attack through Nayem. Taking on Savoki. Savoki hasn't given up. Still battling away. Prasad is there. Play continues. Waranaivailu was under pressure. Fiji have weathered that physical storm. Kusi, the number six for Busaitin, has probably seen enough of tall Fijian frontmen to last him a lifetime. He got a real going over from Osea Vakatalasau in the Amical match. And Sola Wanga, although he's tender in years, he's probably about the same height as Kusi. Kusi's about 6'3", 6'4".
Yeah, Solo comes from a good stock at Ba, same as Osea Vakatalasau.
Well played. That's very intelligent from Mohammed Khan.
Good combination there by the two players who both play their football in New Zealand. Divikesh Deo, the goalkeeper, Mohammed Khan.
Kusi wins the header. Mohammed Sultan works the ball forward. Intelligent header. Releases Naidu, who's against a very determined figure in Mushtaq Malek. Ajaj can't keep it in. Well, this is a good opening spell for Fiji. Well, Malek, just having a word to Nadu. There was something happened off the ball there between the two players. And Nadu's pleading a case for the defence with Mushtaba. Long ball forward. Hughes is forward. Cushioned header by De Paula. Well, this is what Fiji don't really want to see, is the game getting too stretched. But they can counter-attack here through Nadu. Ball given away cheaply. Nyam. Ajaj ahead of him. De Cruz in the box. Alajmi. It's all scrappy in there. Fiji have come away with it. Hughes needs a target. He's got Wanga. Narend Rao. Tuivuna. Oh, Deo's having to come forward for this. This is where Buzatina going to squeeze the game. But now there's a gap between the lines. Picked up by Waranavailu. And he had to release the ball sooner than that. Savoki sold himself early. He's given away a foul on Nayem. You can see there Ravinesh Kumar shouting the instructions that that ball had to be released sooner. Of course, there's only so much you can do from the sideline, isn't there, once the players cross that white line. They're really on their own. Hashem Nayem. Abdullah Al-Khilaf. Abdul Karim Kusi. Giuliano De Paula. Well, he's given that away. And the ball is broken kindly for Al-Khilaf. Now Ajaj. Trying to work onto his right foot. Malek. This is good from Buzaitin. Budesh. Going at the Fijian defence. He's run straight into Sedariki Hughes. Mohamed Sultan. Good work on the ball. And that's an easy turn by Budesh. Nadu's provided cover. He's looking for space to get this ball clear. And he's done it. He's performed very well, Pranil Nadu, under pressure.
Yeah, still remember that stunner that he scored at yes. the playoffs, Gordon. But again, this under-20 boys' heads held high so far, with going on to the 14th minute. Early days yet, but Musaitin definitely in for a scrap here this evening so far.
Well, Amakel have shown already that if you can weather the storm from Buzaitin, that great things can come from that. Here's De Cruz. Sultan. Alajmi. Al-Khilaf free on the left. Not much movement up front for Buzaitin yet. Fiji happy to just sit in and absorb this pressure. Sola Wanga back there doing some defending, and he's given away a free kick.
Trying to do Elsio Vakatalisau there, covering back in defence, the striker.
Well, this is what Vakatalisau did so well for Amakel. Often when he's playing for Barra in the Champions League, he tends to drift out of those defensive duties, looking for a bit of space that he can get the ball and counter-attack. But he was working his socks off to get back in and help his teammates. And the reward for that was a rare and historic victory. Abdullah Alajmi is on the ball. Abdul Karim Kusi is... also forward, he's going to be a target. De Cruz is in there, but that is an awful free kick by any standards. And they've got to put pressure on Fiji by delivering accurate balls, especially when they're from a dead ball situation out wide. Here's Nadu. De Paula manufactures a clever clearance. Nadu, still going. There's a cross. De Paula got enough on it. Go, 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 go. Mohammed Khan for Devinish Dow. Savoki. Al Khalaf. Well, Indra, it's all rather scrappy to begin with from both teams.
Yeah, very scrappy. And just looking at it, it's more like Busaitin playing the pattern of play that the Fijians are used to. And they'd be loving this unconstructive football in the first 16 minutes.
Al Khalaf. Eliel de Cruz. Played his professional football last season in Malaysia. And that's good defending from Garish Prasad. De Cruz. Up against Savoki. And Prasad has done well. Doesn't want to give the ball away there, though. Needs to clear his lines and does.
He did well against Ian Hawke the other night as well when Amical played the Fijian under-20s. Held his ground.
De Cruz. Looked to work himself in for a throw-in. It's fallen to Abdullah Al Khalaf. Mohammed Sultan. Well played by Sidiriki Hughes' skipper. Kusi. Dipala. Clever play from the Brazilian centre half. Prasad's won it. Abdullah Badesh. Dipala. Dipala used to play for Muharraq in Bahrain. He has spent the best part of 7 years in Bahraini football. That's a good tackle. Fair tackle. Well, they keep the ball very well, don't they, Indra Buzatin?
Yeah, they keep the ball very well. And you look at it, those 50-50 challenges at times. The young Fijians are getting out-muscled. And the Bahrainian side, Busaitin, are managing to get that. And the way they build their play from the back is that's what was being talked to about to the Fijian under-20s. That's what they need to do at this level.
We're in the 19th minute at the Truss Arena. It's Busaitin 0, Fiji under 20 0. So far, so good for Ravinesh Kumar and his young team as they continue on the road to New Zealand 2015, the FIFA under 20 World Cup. They can be satisfied with this first stanza against a highly decorated professional club side from the Middle East. And here's a chance for Fiji, perhaps. They've worked it well. The shot, and it's over the top, but not by much. Excellent move by Fiji. Busaitin were shaking.
Yeah, great ball won there by Garish Prasad and led it back to Solawanga as the Fijian supporters in the grandstand smiles on this chilly evening here in West Auckland. But again, Solawanga getting a chance as he did against Amical the other night.
Hughes battling for everything in there. Hisham Naim against Savoki. Tries to beat him for pace, gets across in, it's cleared. Well, this is really encouraging stuff from Fiji under 20. As I said in the build-up to tonight's match, they're going to face opposition that at least as good as this at the FIFA under 20 World Cup. They're going to be playing against teams that have players that are playing in the top divisions in Europe and around the world. It won't be schoolboy football, so to speak. And the more games they get at this type of level against these type of opponents, all the better. Results are almost immaterial compared to the learning they can extract from these sorts of games. Good overlap by Al Khalaf. Still going. Savoki needs to get a tackle in. He's done enough to put Al Khalaf off, who suggests to the referee, Nick Waldron, that he got pushed, but I don't think there was anything in that.
Yes, yeah, Savoki and Tony Tuivuna are two of the rock defenders in the Fijian team, and they both play for Suva in the district level football. Suva will be seeing them in the AFC Champions League next season, and they've been a power of strength to both the Fijian under-20s and also to the Suva side domestically. So a little more game time in over 2 to 3 years. It'll be interesting to see where they end up.
Good shake of the hips from Malek to work that space, but Buzaitin have given it away. Warrenavalu trying to find Garish Prasad. Fiji fighting and battling away for everything, and they've come up with it. Hughes. Cross comes in. Mutton and Singer's in there. Pranil Naidu has joined in. He needs an option. Unless he decides he wants to try and beat Badesh, which he does. Takes a deflection. Goal kick given. Well, I thought it took a bit of a knock off the defender, Abdullah Badesh, but the man who matters clearly disagrees.
It's a confidence booster for these young players to be able to take on these Bahraini and Buzaitin players one-on-one and beat them at times.
Well, all of these Buzaitin players are so quick over 5 yards. They're not going to beat you any sort of longish sprints, as we'll see here. Malek cuts it back for Ajaj, trying to work onto his left foot, involves De Cruz. Fiji have got to be strong, and they have endured the attack and come away with the ball. So a big test for them that they've passed, and that's encouraging. Hughes. Rao. Patient build-up from Fiji. They're not rushing things. Content to just get as many touches on the ball as they possibly can. Tuivuna for Savoki. Prasad. And just breaks down in the middle of the park. And that's perhaps a good free kick to concede, just to ensure that the transition of the ball doesn't reach the top third and put Fiji under pressure. They can reset themselves, organise, and repel this next attack. Buzaitin start again. Budesh here on this right-hand side. Hughes goes to shut him down. Well, that's meat and drink for Divakesh Diao. Tuivuna for Naidu. Clipped in for Hughes. Just can't get a hold of the ball.
Just looking at the Buzaitin players off the ball once those tackles go in, they look frustrated because these young Fijian players are really in those niggling situations, are getting the better of these boys.
And the other thing that I've noticed about Fiji this evening, Indra, is that although the pace of the game is being played probably a lot quicker than they're used to, they're not going in for over-the-top challenges and frustration. They're controlled and physical, and that's a big, big thing at a FIFA event, where if you try and put in any of the tackles that perhaps you're used to in domestic football, you're going to get a yellow card or you're going to get a red card. And so far this evening, after 25 minutes, they've shown great mental discipline and self-control in these areas. Hard but fair, you would say. Here's Naim. Savoki goes to shut down De Cruz. Well, and there's an example of what we were talking about. Physical, but controlled and disciplined. And well within the interpretation of a FIFA official at a FIFA event, I would say. Chested down well by Malek for Badesh. Pradesh is running into a problem here, but he's solved it. He's against Naidu. He'll want to cross. He does early. Nobody takes it. They get a second go. Well, they've got to get on the ball here. Ajaj, that is a quality finish. And Buzaitin are one goal up. And it was just a moment's hesitation. There were two or three opportunities to clear it, and Fiji didn't take them.
Yeah, the defenders, got to point a finger at the defenders there. Sluggish clearance at first, then again, they got a second chance. They couldn't take it away and clear it away from the box. And that, look at the cross coming in again there.
There's the first attempt. The second was with a header. Tui Vuna should have perhaps done a bit more, but when it was clipped up in the air, look at that, he sighted it well, and the finish was of the highest quality.
Yeah, two defenders going on that second ball, and they're not getting it. Ball played through for that. It was just great goal there by Buzaitin. They'll be happy with this, being under the pump, under the cosh for about 27 minutes, and now they finally have taken the lead.
Here's Hughes. Tui Vuna. Hughes again. Naidu. Looking for Matana Singa. Haram under pressure. Scoops it out with his left foot. Good jump by Tui Vuna. Straight to Budesh. The chief supplier of Buzaitin's goal. Well, he benefited from his perseverance, Abdullah Budesh, against two opponents before breaking through to get that cross in. Pranil Naidu spotting Solawanga ahead of him. Matana Singa is in the box. There's the cross. Oh, and it was Hughes on the edge of the box. And, well, I apologise, not Hughes. Hughes is on the ball now. I think it was Waranavailu. Here's a switcher play by Buzaitin on the counter. They've two heading for the penalty area. One is Ajaj. Tui Vuna does enough to get the ball away. Mohammed Sultan. Buzaitin setting up camp midway inside Fiji's territory. Mustaba Malek, well, just completely on the wrong page with Mohammed Ajaj.
Yeah, Buzaitin will be getting more confidence after that goal and trying that. And the Fijian players, on the other hand, they cannot let their heads drop. It's just a goal that they've given away, and they've got to keep on maintaining the play that they've shown so far.
Well, it's a situation that could replicate itself at the FIFA Under 20 World Cup. Fiji will be rank outsiders, let's be realistic about that. And will be up against some of the best teams in the world in their age group. And it's a situation they might have to put away in the memory banks for the future. And figuring out a way, a future mindset to deal with such an occurrence will be uppermost in their thoughts. Haram. Al Khalaf for Kusi. Well, that's given away. A chance for Fiji to perhaps punish Buzaitin. Well, Hughes has given it away, and from a counter-attack to a Buzaitin counter-attack. Clipped in, chance for De Cruz. Oh, he's hit the post. And the follow-through by Mohammed Sultan. Whoa, no, the flag is up for offside.
Yeah. Took a while for the flag to go up, I believe, but the Fijian players all looking towards the assistant. Decision yet to be made, I believe.
Well, referee Nick Waldron going into conference.
Oh, he's given it.
Well, the goal's given. Buzaitin double the lead in the 29th minute through Mohammed Sultan. Plenty of food for thought for the men on that bench. The substitutes have been ordered to warm up. Here's the cross coming in. The first touch bashed against the post, and Mohammed Sultan, well, Indra, your thoughts on that?
Yeah, the three defenders after the goalkeeper got bitten, the rebound, no defender fell back on the line to cover it and cover his goalkeeper, and that proved to be the downfall for the second goal that went in by Buzaitin.
Naidu. Tetariki Hughes making his presence felt on Abdullah Alajmi.
That's also Divikesh Deo making his professional debut, or the international debut for the under-20s here. Not a good start for him. Not to be blamed, though.
No, he looks a young goalkeeper with a big future. He's certainly big in stature, which is always an advantage for an athlete aspiring to ascend the ranks of their chosen sport, particularly with the FIFA Under 20 World Cup. And perhaps, Indra, you can tell us, give us an inside word on the race for the number one jersey for this Fiji Under 20 team.
Divikesh Deo, the missing one in Arumbe, who started against Amical. He is currently the number one choice goalkeeper, who plays for Ba in the local footballing circles. And also Shanil Naidu, who played the very first game in the qualifiers against American Samoa. He also hails from Ba. They produce some very good goalkeepers. Gordy, you would know that. Lysenia Tumba. Sefo Somboto was on the bench as the goalkeeping coach.
The goal-scoring Lysenia Tumba.
Yeah. How could we forget that final against Waitakere United some years back?
Yes, indeed. During that competition, he scored two goals. One against Marist in the Solomon Islands in Honiara. And another against, I think it was, Timanava of Tahiti. That might have even been a free kick rather than a penalty. Savoki and Tetariki Hughes getting into a tangle. It's broken for Naim. Well, look at Buzai team. They're just bursting forward in numbers. Naim tries to get a cross in. Strikes Muhammad Khan. Goes through the legs. Well, Buzai team have just lifted the standard, just another notch. Substitution coming up. I don't know if this is tactical or injury related.
Yeah, they've taken out Warren Ivalu, and they're sending in Chonatani Baksh.
So what's the thought process here, Indra?
Doesn't look like an injury, Gordy. Just looking at Warren Ivalu, no limp, not too attended to by the medical staff. Direct swap.
Tuivuna decides to go long. Sola Wonga, that's a very good touch. Oh, and it just looked as though it struck the hand.
Chonatani Baksh there. First touch of the ball.
First touch of the ball, a literal touch with the hand. And it was a great touch by Sola Wonga just to open up his chest and let the ball take that touch to allow his teammate to run through.
Gordon, Sola Wonga, the striker at the moment for the Fijian under-20s. His strike partner, of Samuela Nambenia, he's still injured with that knee injury that I mentioned earlier, and it's still a 50-50 chance if he will feature at the World Cup. The Fijian coaching staff definitely need to try out a few strikers in that position to ensure that they get a goal-scoring person and to support Sola Wonga up front.
Yes, talking to Ravinesh Kumar, he did say that, you know, at this level, you can see perhaps the greenness of young players when they're presented with goal-scoring opportunities, and I think Sola Wonga's miss against Amical was one such moment. When you get a chance at this level, you have to take it. They don't come by in regular intervals necessarily, and FIFA Age Group World Cups are no different to that. I can recall in 2007 at the Under 20 World Cup, New Zealand playing Gambia, Portugal and Mexico. As Naim has a shot, it's beaten away by Deo. It hasn't gone far enough. It's three. And it's Mushtaba Malek of Buzaitin in the 35th minute. And this has now started to run away on Fiji.
Again, it'll be interesting to see what Malik's goal there, palmed away by Divikesh Deo. He followed it up very well, as you watch it here, the shot that comes in.
Yeah, it was dipping and swerving all the way, and he did his best to beat it out. He came out to try and block it, but it wasn't enough.
Yeah, Tony Tuivuna again getting bitten, and again, his fellow defenders not falling back. So one area that we've noticed that the coaching staff definitely will have to work on. 3-0 after some early promise by the Fijian under 20s.
Well, that looks a painful one, but a fair one. Pranil Naidu went straight through the ball. Mohammed Sultan is in some agony. He's getting to his feet now as we see Ajaj. On return to the point I was making earlier, New Zealand were drawn against Mexico, Portugal and Gambia, and there was a feeling that the match with Gambia would perhaps offer the New Zealand side the best opportunity, but it turned out that they hardly saw a touch of the ball and they were beaten 1-0.
Oh, just straight through the ball by Pranil Naidu, no malice in that challenge.
No, it's just a physical challenge that's ended with the player needing some treatment. I think the point being, Indra, is that when you get a chance at this level, you just have to take it.
And also, with the pools to be drawn in February for the FIFA Under 20 World Cup, it'll be interesting who the Fijians come up against, because then they have about 3 months to prepare for it. And also, talking about the call with the players earlier on over here, and it's nothing compared to what they'll face during the World Cup.
No, that's the middle of winter,
yeah.
And it's wet and it's cold, for sure. Well, Mohammed Sultan is going to go to the sideline. Budesh, his teammate, helping the triage process with the Buzzo team physio.
I think Amical tore up the script when they beat Busaitin. Most were thinking it would be a Busaitin Auckland City final. Amical had other ideas. And just talking to the Amical team as well, Gordon, earlier on, they're willing to help the Oceania brothers, Fiji Under 20, prepare well for the World Cup. Great move from the Amical management.
Yeah, well, they've obviously been the benefits of, or the beneficiaries of the production line of Fijian talent that's come out of places like Bar. Of course, Asava Nangaletha is there, and also Vakatalasau, but there have been others.
It was a proud moment for the Fijians when Asava captained the Amical team in the first game. Unfortunately, he went out. Been ruled out for about 2 months. I spoke to him earlier on.
And what is the nature of that?
He said he's torn some ligament, or just been told it's not serious, that it will require an operation, but scans have revealed that he needs to take about 2 months off. He says Champions League is the important one. He'll rest and he'll be back for that one.
And he'll get a good run-in of preparation as well, the February and March in the domestic competition. So time very much on Asava Nangaletha's side. De Cruz, Savoki, Ajaj, trying to work the ball through his feet. Here's a shot straight into the hands of Dio. That was an easy one for him, but he's tried to rush the counter-attack. This is what Buzzatine are good at punishing. Mohammed Sultan clips in a inviting cross. Nobody's gone for it. Well, Savoki got caught ball watching. And Deo's goal was at the mercy of Abdullah Ajaj. And it's now 4-0 to Buzaitin.
Yeah, that goal, Ajaj, there. Again, the defenders. I would point a finger at the defenders for the Fijian under 20 so far as we watch the replay. The ball coming in.
Here it is. It was clipped in and measured, but Savoki expected the goalkeeper to come. The goalkeeper thought otherwise, and there was no communication, and while that indecision was going on.
Yeah, we saw that in the replay. Savoki looking up to Divikesh Deo, expecting him to come out. Better communication needed in those situations.
Mohammed Sultan. Malek. Well, we saw this in the game with Amical in the opening exchanges. They were able to make mistakes on the ball, Buzaitin, but they were quick enough to recover. So you could have a player having a bad first touch, but he was straight after it and winning it back again. Naidu. Cleared by Kusi.
So far, I've been impressed with some of the Fijian under 20 midfielders. They're trying, but it's just the defense that has let them down. But this is, as we mentioned earlier on Gordian, we reiterated again, this is the learning curve that they need, and these are the kinds of matches that they'll face.
Yes, it's not an OFC age group championship that Fiji are going to. They're going to a FIFA World Cup.
And they're reminded of that at training yesterday. That they'll be facing likes of future, as you mentioned, Messi, who played in this, and also Angel Di Maria.
That's correct. Sergio Romero, the goalkeeper as well, who played in the FIFA World Cup in Brazil for Argentina, as they're beaten in the final by Germany. He played in the 2007 final for Argentina as they won that competition, beating the Czech Republic in the final 2-0. Here's Budesh. De Cruz against Tuivuna. Matanasinghe doing some defending deep in his own half. Malek spreading it wide to Al Khalaf. Abdul Karim Kusi. Malek. Hisham Naim against Savoki. This is where he can turn on the afterburners against Savoki. Gets a cross in. De Cruz, there's too much room there for him. Fiji survive. Well, or do they? It's a mad scramble to get their lines clear. Naidu. Trying to look for options. He's picked out Garish Prasad here on the right, but he's bundled off the ball by double goal scorer Ajaj. De Cruz. Mohamed Khan goes to lock him down. Aljami. Malek. Ajaj. They're really warming into their task, Buzaitin. And this could be well within sight of Eliel De Cruz. We saw him score a free kick against Amikel. Might see the Brazilian fancy another moment like that.
Yeah, Narendra Rao, the culprit there. Taking down Malek. He's got a bit of a Luis Suarez look going there, Malek. See, this is where the defenders need to communicate. They need to talk to each other. Finally, Sivuki guides them.
De Cruz, oof, not far away. It rippled the top of the roof of the net.
Yeah, maybe early days yet, Gordon, but based on the result at the moment, if it stood as it is right now, we'll have an Amical and Auckland City final. What a final. Everyone's looking forward to that one. And the third and fourth place playoffs would be between Busaitin and the Singapore under 23s. And Fiji might meet Bowden Town in fifth and sixth.
Malek, and the ball has gone out. Abdul Karim Kusi got that completely wrong, but he's got a kind bounce of the ball. Savoki's headed it forward for Garish Prasad. That midfield is a real meat grinder at the moment. Anything that goes in there is fair game, along with an opponent. Two minutes additional time will be played. Factoring in the one substitution made by Ravinesh Kumar. And perhaps a stoppage that allowed Mohamed Sultan to receive treatment. Here's a chance for Fiji perhaps to close off the half. Chested down by Hughes, but hacked away by Mushtab Malek. Naidu. This is good from Fiji. Mathena Singer just can't lock the ball in. Needs to be stronger when receiving it to feet. You can't turn into these sorts of players with that type of caliber and hope to get a lucky bounce. More often than not, you're going to walk straight into a gin trap and it's going to snap on you. Here's Hughes.
Yeah, a very interesting point going on with the Fijian footballers. While they are physical in nature of playing, in terms of playing, it's also the body, the way they condition their body to play against top-level teams as such. And we've seen them against the likes of All Whites in the past and also the Australian Socceroos when they were in Oceania.
Oh, chance maybe from this melee that has ensued. Good spell this for Fiji. Naidu's managed to get it away. Hughes has lunged in there, and it's a free kick to Fiji. I think Pranil Naidu needs to get on the ball here.
Yeah, he's going towards the ball. His range.
Definitely well within Pranil Naidu's range. It is 35 metres out. Would have to be some hit. Hisham Haram is not the biggest goalkeeper. He's asked for three in the wall.
This is the other guy, Kolonius Sivuki, who's been taking a lot of free kicks and spot kicks, the penalties for Fiji. Let's see if he can. I think it will most likely him giving it a drive.
Well, if Naidu's got the skill and finesse, Sivuki looks as though he's the one packing all the power. He needs some accuracy, though. And it's deserted him just at the crucial moment as referee Nick Waldron brings the first half to a close. It's been all Byzantine, but it doesn't tell the full story. Fiji under 20, although they haven't created an out-and-out goal-scoring chance, they have had good spells with the ball, but just some lapses in defence have cost them at crucial times, and that is the reason why they trail by 4-0.
Yeah, a lot of team talk needed at halftime here by the two teams as they get in. Byzantine would be more than happy than what they've got now. 4 on the board, more of the same required. Fiji, tighten up the defence. The defenders would be... they'll get any bashing by coach Ravinesh Kumar.
Well, I certainly hope it's constructive and his team can come out in the second half and just readjust some of the defensive lapses that have plagued them certainly midway through the first half. Let's take a look at the highlights of the first half. 5 minutes in. And again, Fiji began the way that they did against Amakel with an opportunity. Haram had to punch that cross clear.
Pranil Naidu, the second ball in.
And this was the interesting one. They got a header on target, and Haram, perhaps to keep himself warm, gave us some acrobatics. Quarter of an hour later, another chance for Fiji. This was a well-worked opportunity, but again, power over accuracy.
You got to hit the target from that range.
25th minute. Some hesitation in the Fijian penalty area. They got two goes at this. Three, if you include that. But Ajaj just had too much power. The marking wasn't tight enough, and the goalkeeper didn't have a chance.
Getting bitten at his near post. He'll not be happy with that.
Another Byzantine goal 4 minutes later. Cleverly worked in. And the ball hit the post from a De Cruz shot. Mohamed Sultan was on hand to just tap it over the line. The marking, not the best. And the Bahrainis were 2 to the good. They didn't have to wait much longer before they were adjusting the scorecard. This long-range shot, dipping. And Divakesh Deo had to palm it away, but he only got it as far as Mushtaba Malek. He got a second bite of the cherry and made it count. A little bit of ball watching in the defence there.
The basic thing of falling back on the line, not being followed by the Fijian defenders.
Mohamed Sultan asked questions. It was a ball over the top, and Ajaj helped himself to a second goal of the night. Sivuki and Deo really didn't communicate with each other. And the marking was, again, a bit ropey. As we see the Curva kids going through their paces on halfway with their mentor, Phil Pickering-Parker. And confirmation at halftime, Buzzi Team 4, Fiji under 20, nil. Rejoin us very shortly for the second half. Welcome back to the Truss Arena for the fourth match of the competition in the OOC President's Cup. It's Amakela Vanuatu taking on Buzzi Team of Bahrain. Well, it's been entertaining stuff, and it was Malik who had the first opportunity to open the scoring. Went too high there. Had to go a lot lower, and he knew it. Good save by Mansale inside the first 60 seconds. 8 minutes later, it was Amakel that could have taken a shock lead. Panagiotis free kick, swirls in, strikes the crossbar, was handled onto the crossbar, and then Bakatalis out. You cannot afford to miss those sorts of chances against a team like
this.
He
snatched at it, didn't he?
Quarter of an hour. Buzzi Team, unsurprisingly, on the attack. Zhaj takes a touch, rifles this shot just over the crossbar. Zhaj again at the centre of things, has a shot, it broke kindly for Naeem, had it in the back of the net, but he was adjudged offside.
Was it offside or did he touch it with his arms? It's a bit of one, such a one half goal over the other there.
And then 42 minutes, Eliel de Cruz broke the deadlock with this free kick, bent it round the wall. Chico Mansali did well to get down to his left, but not well enough. You see here, just bounced in that awkward area for a goalkeeper.
It did look like the wall fragmented, and perhaps we give the credit here. They start moving a little bit. Oh, he's just hit that so well. And the dip on it as well would have made it exceedingly hard for Mansali to save it.
So, halftime at the Truss Arena in Auckland. It's Amakela Vanuatu 0, Buzzi Team of Bahrain 1. 8 minutes into the second half. The equaliser from Francois Sakama. The marking was loose. It was non-existent, in fact. And Hussein Haram couldn't stop it. And it was from this delivery from Nikos Panagiotis. Beautiful ball in. Sakama up. Got his header on target. The goalkeeper could do nothing. And DePaola will get a good look at the lack of marking here.
Well, what it is they've been drifted in there with Caltech and Bakatalasau and left Sakama all on his own.
6 minutes later, chance, and de Cruz gets it off target. That was as close as Buzzi Team came, really, to troubling Chico Mansali. He didn't have much to do. 68th minute, this touch from Sakama. A second, gloriously going beyond Kusi, but he lacked power. 79 minutes. Then here it came. Look at this. Popped up by Sakama. Vakatalasau let it go. Panagiotis with the goal of the tournament so far. True class. Absolute quality.
That's a superb. Technically, you can't get better than that. I mean, he scored a pretty special goal the other night as well.
7 minutes to go. Panagiotis could have added to Buzzi Team misery, but this wonderful save from Hussein Haram. And with five to go, Ian Hogg missed out Haim. And then Bajaj tried the bicycle kick. It was it was well wide in the end. And you could see there on Grazia's face, they felt that this game was well within their grasp of winning, and that's how it proved to be. Let's get some post-match reaction.
Can you tell us what you thought of your side's performance?
الفريقين لعبوا مباراة زينة اجتازوا الفرصتين اللي حصلوهم الفريق الأحمر على الفريق الأبيض البسيتين حصلوا الفرص دي ترجموها أهداف المباراة في مجملها يمكن تليق بالفريقين المباراة قدموها أحسن عرض أتمنى أن يلعبون يوصلون على المباراة دي
we played good they created many chances they create many chances and they score. The different way they score the chance we create.
An interesting tactic, perhaps, not to use your substitutes. Was there a reason behind that?
ضغط على الفريق في منطقته محاولة ان اللعب الكرة الأرضية أفضل لنا يمكن انخدعوا شوي في الكرات تسرع فيها في منطقة الثلث الأخير ضيعوا علينا فرصتين ثلاث كانوا أجمل ما يكون أن يسجلون فيها أهداف المباراة لازم فيها غلط لازم فيها صح اللي بياخذ الغلط معناته بياخذ الخسارة واللي بياخذ الصح بياخذ الفوز
We try to play pressure on the team and play on the ground, but we missed the chance. Should we get back, Captain?
I'm going to put that on number 9.
We try to press in number 9 because he's the best player on the team.
So next match is against the Fiji Under-20s. Can we expect a strong performance and perhaps you're after the 3 points again?
نحاول
ان نكون في المركز الرابع او الثالث ان شاء الله.
We try to make a third or fourth. We then make it a third one.
Congratulations, a well-deserved victory. Are you happy with what the boys did out there on the pitch tonight?
Yes, honestly, I'm very happy with my boys. I think they did what we learned in the training. So to me as a coach, I'm happy with them.
Not a lot of information on Busaitin ahead of this match. So how did you approach it, given that you weren't sure about your opponent?
To me, the game against Busaitin is a good for us. I think those who organize this tournament, it especially is very, very important for us as team who go to next O-League. So we are one of them. So I think not just only for this win, but also for our preparation for the next O-League.
Currently at the top of the group, going into the playoffs, but obviously we have to wait until Friday's matches. Is there a side that you're hoping to meet on Sunday?
Yeah, as I said in the first place, every team we come here, we respect them. I know they are good teams, so. We need to work a lot to go for the next stage.
Like the most awesomest thing ever in like the whole wide world.
This is very nice, a beautiful place and beautiful weather and with very friendly people.
Very exciting. It's a new experience.
Yeah.
And you get to learn new stuff.
Yes, we are our future maybe will be a coach. So we're starting from now.
I've learned that they really miss their kids there and that coming here is like a new experience and a new like journey. Yeah. And that Bahrain is very hot.
We all leave our family and our children there. And we came here to find our children. They are very friendly and we have a very nice time with them.
hit the ball here, not here, and to pass the ball if you want to get a goal.
It's like preparing you for, well, if you want to play soccer, for the next step ahead.
Yes, we are very excited. All people, they have picture with children and like this. We are very excited.
How friendly and kind they are, and always happy, and it's inspiring.
Yes, we are coming here and we are get a long distance to get here. I hope we will go a nice job here, and all people will have fun when they say our name.
We're back at the Truss Arena, halftime in the match between Buzai Teen and Fiji Under 20s, and it's the team from Bahrain who lead by 4-0. And Indra, it's a fair reflection on what we've seen, but obviously not the whole story.
Yeah, definitely. I think they started very well, as we mentioned, Gordon, the Fiji Under 20s against the Buzai Teen team. That Buzai Teen, when they got that goal, the first and the second, they slowly crept into the match and put that pressure. The under-20s were not able to take, conceding two more to be down by four. And I believe the Fijian under-20s are about to replace their goalkeeper, Divikesh, with Shanil Naidu, who actually was the second-choice goalkeeper in the OFC playoffs in Suva, Fiji Islands. Mm.
Well, Misiwani Norubi played in the first game, so all three goalkeepers will have had some time out on the pitch. And Andrew, we were talking during the off-air segment of tonight's broadcast about just how important this type of game is to find out just where your weaknesses are and to identify exactly what those might be and then have time to remedy them.
Yeah, as we see Shanil Naidu into the team. But definitely, Gordon, when they played and won that championship, they did not have it all their way. We remember that game against Vanuatu and then the Solomon Islands. And this is the test that they're finally getting. And these are the kinds of tours and matches they need before they get ready for the World Cup in about 6 months from now.
And the other side of the coin is, if you don't get difficult games like this now, you could set up a 16 tournament and play five weaker teams, beat them all, and then think everything's fine.
Yeah, definitely. And that will not be a fair reflection on what the team is, the weaknesses, etc. And also, I think this is a great concept that has helped the Fijians to play in their own backyard in Oceania against teams like Buzai Teen and Amical.
Oh, and there's a trouble.
Not a good first touch.
No, for the new goalkeeper. Well, very difficult for a goalkeeper to come in to a game cold like this, but he's going to have to find his feet and his hands pretty early on. if Fiji are to not sustain any further damage on the scoreboard. Bereish, Mohamed Sultan. That's lifted over the top of Mohamed Khan, but he's recovered. Naidu. Here's Wanga. That's broken kindly for Fiji. There's a shot. It's a weak one, but they've got a free kick. And this is Pranil Naidu country right here.
Yeah, I think he should be given this ball. He was talking about it the other day. He said if he got a few chances in this area against Amical. Naren Rao drawing that foul as we see comes in. Straight through.
Well, it's the elbow that's gone into the side of the opponent's head. Al Khalaf is rolling around on the ground and might have hurt his back in the fall. Well, Buzai team didn't use any substitutes in their first match. That was quite a curious set of circumstances. And the question was posed at the post-match flash interview, but no answer was forthcoming. It got lost in translation, shall we say.
Yeah, it was very interesting. For the entire duration of the 90 minutes losing to Amical, they didn't change any play, and so far they haven't done. Fiji have made two changes already.
Well, Khalifa Al-Ziyani might have a substitution forced on him here. Al Khalaf goes in and his... Oh, well, I can see there. They've both gone in with elbows, to be honest. Al Khalaf went head height with his. And he got one in his lower back, perhaps in the kidneys. There was nothing in it. It was two players going to contest the ball physically and fairly. And Naidu has got the ball, by the way.
Yeah. He's not having a good Auckland evening here on a Friday. Yeah, the signal goes to the bench to make a change. Then they say not yet.
So play about to restart. Hisham Haram, the goalkeeper, asking for 1, 2, 3. There's four assembling in the wall. Pranil Naidu standing over it. Nick Waldron bringing that wall back the requisite measurement. Matasingia is in the wall, so... Hisham Haram's not the tallest of goalkeepers, too. This could play into Pranil Naidu's advantage. I don't think Savoki's going to hit this. He's lined up for a run at the ball as if he were to hit it, but it's the left foot of Pranil Naidu that you want to keep your eyes on.
Yeah, Haram is dwarfed by his defenders in front of him.
Well, we've seen one Brazilian free kick at the OFC President's Cup. It was hit by Eliel de Cruz, who's on the pitch tonight. And with a young man with a reputation for doing the same on the ball now. What can he produce? Oh, Fiji trying to get the ball over the line. It's headed off the line. It's hit the post. It's in. Fiji have scored, much to the delight of the Truss Arena.
Naren Rao running away.
And it looks like it's Naren Rao who got the final touch on the ball. And it's Fiji smiles all round and a real confidence boost.
But you've got to put it down to Pranil Naidu's drive in that free kick as we watch it again. Here he comes, he drives it over the wall, tapped away by the goalkeeper. Tony Tuivuna tried it, he didn't, then the melee, and then Naren Rao just flicks it over.
Badosh gets a head on to it, it hits the post. Badosh, oh, I tell you what, yeah. That's quite possibly an own goal.
Yeah.
Fiji won't care. They've started the second half in a stirring fashion. A goal on New Zealand soil. Imagine if they could do that in May, June of next year. A precursor to the FIFA Under 20 World Cup. And the Fijian supporters have turned out in force tonight. Clearly happy. This is a red card for Tony Tuivuna. And this is a moment of madness. Tony Tuivuna has lashed out, and it's Mushtab Malek who's been the victim of rash act. And this is exactly what Fiji didn't want, to pull a goal back and then within 90 seconds go a man down for an act of petulance and ill discipline. Here you can see Mushtab. Well, Mushtab has played for this, and he's got it, but Tony Tuivuna cannot retaliate, and that's what he's done. But the player, yes, and he's got a yellow card as well. Now, Nick Waldron has got this completely right here. My fear was that Tuivuna had been the victim of some simulation or foul play. Well, the cameras followed the ball there, but what took place was Mushtab Malek pushed Tony Tuivuna, and Tuivuna shoved out. Yellow card, red card. So real drama in the opening 8 minutes, and Buzai T now have had their lead cut to 3 goals, but they have a one-man advantage.
Yeah, the Fijians will need to keep their cool here. When that red card was flashed to Tony Tuivuna, a few of the other players came barging in. They need to keep their cool. 10 players, one man down, long walk for Tony Tuivuna behind Musata in goalmouth to the change room.
Here's a look at the goal. It was an awkward one for Haram to take care of. It bounced just in front of him. There was a melee here. Budesh hit it against the post, and then he got it at the second attempt, you might say. And De Paula tried to kick it out, but it was already over the line. So an own goal. Well, we were talking about the discipline that's required to compete at a FIFA event, Indra. And although that was a difficult one because there was a provocation of Tony Tuivuna, you just can't react.
No, you can't. Oh.
And there's another. And it's another red card.
Another red card. Solowanga. I just mentioned that, Gordon. They need to keep their cool. They can't lash out.
Well, they've paid for it. You have to say that if you think the FIFA Under 20 World Cup is going to be any different in terms of the interpretation of the law of the game, you'd be mistaken, you'd be wrong. Now, De Paula goes to ground here, and he brings the player down. That's a free kick for Fiji right there. But this, lashing out at the player with your studs, is just asking for trouble.
9 players now. What a first 10 minutes or so we've had.
Well, we've seen the best and the worst of Fijian football in the space of just 4 minutes.
They've made a change, Busai team.
And there is Solowanga heading for the dressing room to join Tohi Tuivuna. 8 players in the outfield for Fiji. It's going to be backs to the wall stuff for the next 31 minutes. Well, it'll be 35 minutes, won't it? We're in the 55th. The ball worked in. It's headed clear. Well, every stoppage is going to be a welcome respite for Fiji. Matanasinghe. Malek. Hoisted clear. That's a good touch by Ajaj. Mohamed Sultan switches play here to the left. Eliel de Cruz uses Naeem's run as a decoy. Ajaj plays it through and it's blocked just in the nick of time. Fiji survive.
Yeah, the eight outfield players now will have to do the task of the striker that they're lacking, Solowanga, and also Tony Tuivuna, the defender.
Malek. Ball headed out by Narayan Rao. What an explosive start to the second half of this game. We've had a known goal and two red cards, both to Fiji. Hughes. Punched forward. Haram.
It's a wild clearance.
Savoki. Kusi. Falam Rizzi pushing it forward. The ball's cut back. That's easy for Chanel.
What's happened here is Pranil Naidu has fallen back into where Tony Tuivuna was playing from his outer wide left midfielder to cover for defense, playing now with Shoaib and also together with Colinio Sivuki.
Well, Pranil Naidu just checking with the referee that he got a good view of that tackle. It was fairly won and fiercely contested. That's a good ball in. Brings the goalkeeper off his line. He didn't give a call, and the centre half was forced to take matters into his own hands. Here's Hughes. Savoki. Pranil Naidu. He's looked very comfortable at this level tonight, Pranil Naidu. One or two of his teammates haven't quite met that standard. Plenty of space out there on the Truss Arena now. Was only got 20 players on the pitch.
They'll do this to draw out the Fijian defenders who are lacking the numbers.
I'd be inclined to have every play behind the ball and just sit in and try and defend this. They've got half an hour to do it. That goal-scoring comeback is now a distant memory for Fiji. It's all about hard work and graft now. That's a clever back heel. Mohammed Sultan trying to get the better of Narayan Rao. Palamretzi for Lajmi, now Kusi, De Paola.
Let's put it this way, this is another scenario that could pop up again at the FIFA Under 20 World Cup, whereby intimidation by the oppositions or the opponents will play a part in the major and crucial matches. Players who are professionals who know how to draw these kind of things.
And I think there's some lessons to be learned from teams that have represented Oceania previously at the Under 20 World Cup. I mentioned Tahiti qualifying in 2009 and going to Egypt, and they suffered three very heavy defeats. But there was one match in particular, I think it was against Nigeria, where they had one or two red cards of their own and had to see out the rest of the match just defending. Now, I believe the scenario in that group was for all three of Tahiti's opponents to try and get as many goals as they possibly could, which would have determined where they ended up in the round of 16 draw. And it wouldn't hurt to take a look at those games on video if possible, just to see where those flashpoints occurred, because I don't think that they would have been too dissimilar to what we saw here, where there was a bit of a confrontation take place and an element of provocation, but it's how you react to that provocation that counts, really. And on that score, Sola Wonga in particular didn't really do himself any favours, and Tony Tuivuna, who also got a push, he reacted, and he was the one who got punished the heaviest.
Pranil Naidu has played a good game tonight, despite all the drama we've had in the second half. He's kept his calm, he's kept his composure, he's gone on those runs. It was he who took that free kick which eventuated in that goal, that own goal that gave Fiji and 20s a goal in this tournament.
He's definitely a player for me who falls into the Roy Krishna category. He's got a big future ahead of him if he wants to grasp it. Here's Naim. Fiji back in numbers, checking onto his right foot, Naim. He's got help from Alajmi. The long-range shot wasn't far away at all. You can see Alajmi just line this up and get underneath it, and it wasn't too far off the target.
Trying to pick the right top-end corner of Shanil Naidu's goal.
Well, Bucks really hasn't had much to do since he came on, has he? It's been all frantic, frenetic, dramatic and exciting, but perhaps not in the way that we had hoped. Bucks. Savoki with a cross. It's a good one. But, oh, and not far away. That's Girish, some strike.
Yeah. Girish Prasad there just taking his chance. He's trying to bent it at the last minute, but he didn't. But a great attempt by him.
Two good moments for Fiji, down to nine men. And just wonder, that's the type of ball that a player like Sola Wonga would love to get on the end of at the top of the six-yard box. Unfortunately, he wasn't there to experience it. Mohammed Sultan. De Cruz. Kusi. Alajmi. De Cruz. And this is all Buzz 18 have to do now. It's just work this Fijian team left and right across the park. Probe for openings and just grind them down.
Considering they're down to 9 players and down by 3 goals on the scoreboard, they're holding their own, trying to keep it at a minimal.
Yes, it's going to take everything they have to do that. They just want to be filling these gaps as best they can. But one's appeared here on the left. Nayem. Oh, it's stayed in. Now Fiji might have a little bit of a go at an attack here. But numerically disadvantaged. They're unable to find other options. Now play broken and fragmented, and they could get caught out. De Cruz. Sultan.
One again.
Well, see, the ball can take unfortunate little breaks like that, and Buzz 18 are going to benefit from it. Cedric Hughes battling for everything in there for Fiji.
He's also had a good game, Cedric Hughes.
He has. He's played very well tonight for...
He's the captain in the absence of Charlie Dreloa.
Played very well for his country this evening. Well, you can see now that the centre-backs have pushed right up high into the Fiji under 20 half. They're getting ever closer, patiently trying to work gaps against this Fijian side that's down to 9. Falamretsi. Minutes to go. It's a long time. And a chance. Offside flag is up.
They will take this result based on how many players they've got on the field at the end of 90 minutes. Maybe try to hit them on the counter when they do get a chance. What Colin Yusivuki is doing at times when Fiji does go up and attack, he's pushing up to try and pressure the Buzz 18 defense with his physical nature. In the absence of Solawanga, with Gabriele left by himself up front.
Yeah, they need some type of outlet to take this pressure off. Malek down the right. De Cruz at the near post. Nayem is checked to the top of the box. He's cut it back, and the goalkeeper spills it. He gets it at the second attempt. And perhaps Fiji deserved a bit of luck. Kusi should win this. Cedricki Hughes has outjumped him. Can you believe it? What a spring. And oddly enough, Indra, we've had 24 minutes. We're in the 25th minute of the second half, and Fiji leading it by a goal to nil with 9 men.
Yeah, Cedricki Hughes, a grand leap. This is another player, Gori, that we've got to look out for in the months and years to come. Playing for Fiji, obviously, and Rewa in the domestic league. His leap there against the taller Buzz 18 defenders showed his commitment.
Here's another look at Mujtaba Malek. He got to the byline, cut it back. It was a lovely cut back, and Badaish, who scored the own goal, got a header on it, and it wasn't powerful enough to trouble the goalkeeper. He no doubt is thinking about how he can balance this ledger that he's thrown out of whack with... That 1-2 he played off the post before heading into his own goal. Here's Baksh. Easy one for Kusi. Takes it on the chest. Phelim Ratsey falls over. Prasad, that's a sloppy one. Picked up by Sultan. Now Naeem Ajaj. Well, that's interesting that that free kick went Fiji's way, but they'll take it.
Yeah, Prasad falling back after that Arab on his part.
You can see here Naeem had the ball, and then it was just the arm around the waist that caught the eye first of all, but if you look at it from the angle that Nick Waldron and the referee saw it, then you can perhaps understand the decision. They've shown incredible amounts of courage, Fiji.
Pretty Naidu pops up on this right-hand side now to deliver the cross into the box. Kulini Sivuki goes up. Fiji's got to be careful. They've got to leave a few defenders behind. At the moment, only Mohammed Khan, who's the only one at the back.
Clear free kick. Alajmi was beaten, all ends up, and decided that Garish Prasad was not going to go anywhere. That's a good ball in. Maybe too close to the goalkeeper. Just a lack of options and a lack of height without Wanga there. Oh, and this is a good ball. Flag stays down. Goalkeeper comes out. Mohammed Khan can't prevent the ball ending up in the back of the net, and it's a hat-trick for Mohammed Ajaj. And this was what you said could happen, Indra.
Yeah.
On a counter-attack. And a hug for his coach, Khalifa Alzayani.
Yeah, that's what happened. Everybody pushed up. Mohammed Khan was the only one left at the back. Tried his best to cover. Still celebrating his hat-trick.
Well, he's come 14,000 kilometres to New Zealand from Bahrain. And it was just over the line. Mohammed Khan spared the ignominy of being notched up as an own goal scorer alongside Abdullah Budesh tonight. So Buzai Teen lead Fiji under 20s by 5-1. And that's given short by Hughes. Naeem trying to work into a space. Can't get the crossover. Savoki's ball's a good one. Nothing to sing it. Right idea. Hughes has got a foot on it, but he might have got too much. Well, he's done well. Taking on Budesh. And it's moments like that that give me encouragement that this Fiji team's got some ingredients about it that can be pulled together into an effective unit ahead of the Under-20 World Cup. It's all about stringing them together and keeping your mental strength and discipline firmly locked in. And at the moment, that's been lacking. As we see Buzai Teen on the attack, they've got De Cruz to the left. Oh, and a mistake by Alajmi, but it's going to be picked up by Malek. Abdullah Budesh. Spots Naeem, who's popped up on the right. There's a cross. It's a good one. It's number six. And it's Celil De Cruz with his second goal of the tournament.
Yeah, the cross coming in. The stooping header off the goalkeeper, Shanil Naidu, straight into the back of the net. That's their sixth goal. And definitely now, after holding them out for after the start of the second half with their own goal that was given to them, and then on two red cards, they're finally starting to open up. You see, good header. Celebrates in the real Brazilian style.
Two goals to Celil De Cruz for the tournament in two matches.
And Buzai Teen will make a double change.
Jonathan Baksh. Nice swivel of the hips. But overdoes it. Sultan. Ajaj, the hat-trick scorer. This is good from Naim. Buzai team smell more goal-scoring opportunities. Goes to the near post. Easy one for Chenille.
De Cruz was asking for that ball at the far post. He was all by himself, unmarked.
Well, Padesh is withdrawn. And it's Mohamed Abidal.
Sounds like Eric Abidal.
Sounds like Eric Abidal. Does he play like Eric Abidal?
We'll get to see.
We'll get to find out.
Abdul Raham Aldasari about to come in as well. 11.
Val Ramsey's throw. It's a short one. Baksh has picked it up. Oh, dear. Well, I think...
it looked a bit...
Val Ramsey played for it and got it. You have seen that from Buzai team now and again. Perhaps par for the course in the league they play in. And here's that other change you discussed just a moment ago. Abdul Rahim Aldosari.
Naim going off.
So this isn't going to be any easier for Fiji. Yep. Two pairs of fresh legs.
Be something for the review later, Gordon. Moments that change games, even though the scoreline was a bit high for the Fijians to maybe eventually come back, but moments that do decide a match, and in a tight contest, if such a thing happened, it will definitely be not easy work for the Fijians to stay in that match.
Yeah, there were key moments that changed the context of a performance, and certainly if you were looking for positives. Well, Fiji under 20 came out after a very difficult first half and scored a good goal. And they were back in the match. And then when the pressure really went on, two players in two particularly pressurized moments just couldn't keep their heads. Now, Jaj can add to the pain here. But he's failed. He's failed miserably. You really have to do much better than that. He probably could have taken another touch.
He knows that. Shake off the head there as he walks, runs back into his position. He did everything right but this. Trying to bed it into the top left corner of Chenille Naidoo's goal.
Inside the final 10 minutes. Fiji under 21. Buzai team 6. Of course, there was another game played earlier today. Auckland City defeated Boden Town of the Cayman Islands by 9-0. Aldosari. Valamretzi plays Mohamed Sultan. Giuliano De Paola. De Cruz. Aldosari. That's not a great first touch. And that wasn't the best of control from Matanasinghe. Now, De Cruz, bundled over by Savoki. Free kick.
Any takers on who's going to take this one?
Well, Abdul Karim Kusi is coming forward, provides a cursory glance, but this is exactly the same position that Eliel De Cruz hit his goal against Samakel. It might be a couple of yards further out, but it certainly has sort of range. Now, when he took it from this position 2 nights ago, he curled it around the right-hand side of the wall and just got it to dip and bounce in front of Chika Mansale. You can see there that Chanel Naidu has taken up that position, so he's given himself a big chance here. And he's gone the other side, and the goalkeeper read it, and read it well. Wants to watch the 6 seconds here. Yeah. Hoisted forward, looking for Jonatani Bakhsh. Fadlan Retzi has fouled and earns a free kick.
Yeah, Fijians will bring in Matiasi Toma. He had a decent outing against the Amical side the other night, playing in defence.
Prasad can't get a charge. Sultan, De Paula, Kusi with space to move into, finds Ajaj, who chests it and lays it off of Mohammed Sultan, who theatrically wound up for a shot and decides to play it to his back four. So Buzai team pulling all the strings here. Eldesari gives it away, and Fiji get some possession with Mohammed Khan. Prasad. Savoki needs an option. And this is where it's starting to break down for Fiji.
It's the numbers as well, Egodi. They do not have the numbers to support each other at times.
And those legs must be getting heavy. Oh, and that's too casual from Buzai team. Garish Prasad, Sedariki Hughes, good touch, excellent touch from the skipper. He looks more at home in midfield. The first game he played up front with Solawonga, and he looked a bit of a lost figure. Here's Naidu. Might try and work himself a corner if he can.
Yeah, as I mentioned, Sedariki Hughes, a natural midfielder. He was only converted to a striker at the Battle of the Giants, the local tournament in Fiji, where he played for Rewa and scored the winning goal. So he started as a striker here for the Fiji under-20s. And Matiasi Toma being brought onto the field of play. And Gabriele Matanisinga goes off the striker.
Well, this match has passed Matanisinga by for the large part. Once he lost Solawonga, he was really just playing against four players by himself.
And Matiasi Toma, Gori, you would know the two famous Toma names from Fijian footballs, Varesa and Viliame. That's the nephew.
Viliame Toma, yes. Very well-known Fijian name in football around Fijian and Oceania circles. Well, there seems to be a conversation going on.
Pranil Naidu. Again. into the final 4 minutes, but whatever added time will be shown by the fourth official. Musai team could say comfortably now, getting maximum points out of this game. Fiji under 20s, a lot of review they'll be doing, not only now, but in the next few months, as to how they fared in this tournament. What were the weaknesses? What were the strengths? Who are the players they need to polish? Who are the players who have reached the level that they need to go up another level as well? So it's all those interesting aspects off the field that are as important as on the field performance.
Absolutely, because while the pitch is the main arena where everything is decided, there are small inches won off the park in terms of the training, the preparation, how the media is handled and all of the things that go with it. You don't get the same atmosphere and level of event management, if you like, at an OFC event as you do at a FIFA event. It just becomes a massive challenge. Here's Aldosari trying to work onto his right foot. The shot, good save. Wonderful save by Chenille. Good height for him to get his hands on it.
One of the beneficiaries of the OFC goalkeeping coach course that was held in Fiji.
I believe that was ex-All Whites goalkeeper James Bannatyne who conducted that as a FIFA instructor, as we see Aldosari work himself onto the right foot. And good save by Chenille Naidoo. Corner comes in and it's hit the back of the net. And it's Eliel de Cruz. In the 88th minute, Buzai Teen now lead Fiji by 7-1.
He just towed over the Fijian defenders there with that header.
Well, it was a superb finish. Look at that. The marking by Mohamed Khan. He didn't go all the way with his man, and in the end, all that was left to do was steer the ball into the back of the net.
Yeah, the heads go down, but this is, as we mentioned, Gordon, and from your experience as well, being FIFA events, this is good to get this out of the way now, rather than getting what at the World Cup, and this is a perfect preparation stage for this team.
Well, that's right.
This is what similar things that will happen.
Exactly. You have to play these types of teams to know what your weaknesses are. There's no use going out and playing matches and going on unbeaten into unbeaten scenarios and tournaments or whatever if you're going to go to May, June and believe that everything is ticking along nicely when perhaps at a higher level, when you get an examination like Fiji's getting here tonight, you suddenly find that you're in all sorts of trouble. Fiji have learned the hard way, but it's an ongoing process. And it's November 2014. They've got 6 full months of preparation left. Buzai Teen, the cross goes to the far post. Chance to cut it back, but Pranil Naidoo puts it into the stands.
Yeah, Gordon, the other thing too is the quality of opponents that they'll come up against in the next few months. Leaving this tournament aside now with one game left to go on Sunday, they need to be playing teams at a very high level. They need to be playing teams that are professional, that are players who play week in, week out in the top leagues. I'm not saying that they'll get matches against the top teams from around the world, but whatever opposition they come up against, if they are similar to what we've seen tonight, like Buzai Teen, and believe me, that will really give these boys a lot of learning, and the learning curve will definitely drive upwards rather than playing easier teams, as you mentioned, and winning everything or having a good performance and the curve going down with four
That's
minutes
right.
of minimum time additional. For this game.
And it sounds perhaps negative to say, but it is an under 20 FIFA World Cup, and really the long term vision would have to be to see just what sort of impact these young players will make in the future for the Fijian national team.
I would like to see at least 3 or 4 players from this side achieve what Roy Krishna has achieved so far playing for the Phoenix from his humble beginnings in Lambasa. He played for the under 20 team on this ground.
Yes.
He's gone on to play for Phoenix.
That's right. Yeah. Absolutely. This is where it all began. Back in 2007, January 2007, he finished the Golden Boot winner, I believe, at that tournament. And they finished just out of the running for a place in Canada, as we spoke earlier in the broadcast. That was a very good Fiji side. That's a good ball.
The other thing too is I'm just looking at the skipper Haram of the goalkeeper and skipper of the Musai team side. The goalkeeper from the back needs to be commanding his players. This is modern day football where goalkeepers need to be talking. I'm not particularly just saying it on the 20 boys. It's also back in Fijian football circles where just one or two goalkeepers who usually talk. That's where the goalkeepers play that major role in defense.
Here's Giuliano De Paola. The raking pass, it's straight to Jonathani Baksh. I quite like the look of Garish Prasad as well. He's another who hasn't stopped working all night. He's got some good touches and adds a lot going forward, but also lending a hand in defence. For me, the players who stand out for Fiji, Pranil Naidu, Garish Prasad, Setariki Hughes, Savoki appears to be carrying an injury at the moment.
Yeah,
seems to be hobbling.
Yeah, hobbling.
Aldosari.
Yeah, so they definitely will be missing Solo Wanga and Tony Tuivuna for the game against Modern Town for the 5th and 6th playoff on Sunday. That's a 1 p.m. local time. Sivuki looks like he's picked up a knock.
Well, from what I've seen of Modern Town over two games and Fiji under 20, I think that's a game that realistically Fiji under 20 are capable of winning that game, because I think player for player they've got more mobility than Modern Town. Modern will be perhaps struggling for numbers in terms of freshening up their squad, whereas Ravinesh Kumar has more at his disposal. There's a shot from Mohamed Sultan. It's way off target. I think the best way to judge the performance of Fiji under 20, perhaps, and perhaps the coach and the players, is after the FIFA Under 20 World Cup, rather than at this present point. They've come 6 months down the track of a preparatory program, and they've another 6 months to go. So it's really just a program that's halfway through its life, its shelf life. There's a cross, straight across the face of goal.
Maybe after the Under 20 World Cup, sir, looking at it, give it another 5 years, most of these players will be about 23, 24 by then. That's where I think Fijian football will start to reap the benefits of what is happening right now.
Well, there is the final whistle, and referee Nick Waldron confirming what we've known for some time, that Buzaitin have won the match. They've done so in considerable style, winning 7-1. And a difficult night for Fiji. A night in which they saw two players sent off, Solo Wanga and Tony Tuivuna, both for retaliation, essentially. And so the steep learning curve for Fiji continues as they head toward the FIFA Under 20 World Cup in New Zealand next year. So the OFC President's Cup final will be Amakel versus Auckland City at 7 p.m. on Sunday. And the playoff for third place is Buzaitin versus Singapore under 23, leaving Fiji under 20 to face Modern Town in the playoff for fifth. And a happy Buzaitin side there, as we look back on the highlights of a dramatic second half. This moment resulted in a free kick, which Pranil Naidu bent around the wall just in front of Hisham Haram, and then it was a goalmouth scramble to try and get that ball over the line.
Narendra just flicked it over.
And then Badesh gets it, heads it onto his own post, and then tucks it into the back of the net. It was harum-scarum stuff, and Fiji were just trying to throw bodies in put some power on it. Badesh was the unfortunate player who headed it into his own post, got a second bite of it, but I think the momentum of his opponent also helped push the ball over the line. 63rd minute, Naeem was on the attack. Spots Lajmi, who fancies a shot from distance, and it was just a yard high and wide. Savoki rifled this cross into the penalty area, and then Garish Prasad with the right foot volley. That was some strike, I tell you what.
Just needed a touch and it would have gone in.
And then Buzaitin on the counter-attack. Ajaj popped it over the top of Chanel, and Mohammed Khan tried to acrobatically flick it off the line, and it was already over before he could even touch the ball. And by this point, of course, Fiji were down to 9 players. They had 2 red cards, as I said, Tuivuna and Wanga, both sent off. Quarter of an hour remaining. Buzaitin hadn't stopped scoring, and Eliel de Cruz with a stooping header. Johnny Tani Baksh not tight enough with the Brazilian striker, who just rifled it into the back of the net. 11 minutes to go, and Mohammed Khan got in all sorts of trouble. Ajaj cuts back inside, but the ball bobbled and his strike went wide of the target. 87th minute, corner whipped in, and Eliel de Cruz lost his marker again, and it was a free header. Mohammed Khan went with him and then stopped, and you saw the result there. So let's get some post-match reaction. Jacqueline Tran Van is with Mohammed Ajaj.
Ajaj, congratulations. A hat-trick tonight, which must be quite pleasing from your perspective.
Yeah, sure. I'm happy. I want to thank everyone, my teammates, my coach, for giving the faith on me. And thanks to New Zealand.
Can you tell us about that game? I think from our perspective, a better performance and something, a better performance from your team, but also what the fans were expecting to see from your side?
Yes, this is our team. The last match when we played against Amicali, we were nervous. But today, each individual gave 100% of his performance. That's why we get, you can see the fan board, and you can see that's at 7.
So your next match will be for 3rd and 4th place. You'll be playing Singapore under 23. Have you had a chance to watch that side yet?
Yeah, we actually watched them against Auckland City, and we hope we give the same performance as today and we win.
Yeah. So you think you can nab that 3rd place here
hopefully,
at the RC President's
hopefully.
Cup?
It all depends on us players and on listening to the coach.
Yeah. Awesome, thank you.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Hat-trick hero Mohammed Ajaj giving his views of tonight's game.
More smiles tonight than the first match day that they had.
Yeah, that was some game they played against Amical, and some result for the Vanuatu club side, who aren't even the champions of their country, we should note. And we're with Ravinesh Kumar, coach of Fiji under-20s.
Well, Ravinesh, we saw a better performance from Buzaitin than what we'd seen in their first game, and unfortunately it's for you it's a loss, but were you happy with the performance from your side? Obviously some not so cool heads might have let you down.
Yeah, I think so. They could not sustain the pressure from a professional team and professional players, and they lost their self, which they should control their self in situations like this, playing with professional players, and this let us down.
Obviously hard for them against a side like Buzaitin, which as you say is a professional club, but I think we saw some bright spots from them. They held them off in the second half despite being only 9 men.
Of course, yes. The effort of the boys in the second half was good. They were knowing that they are only 9, and they did their best, whatever they could. And I would say hats off to the boys who played in the second half, and they sustained them and resist them from going more goals.
Yeah. So obviously a learning curve for you guys here, and a good opportunity to get some preparations in ahead of the World Cup. Next game, Boden Town from Cayman Islands for the 5th and 6th position. What are you expecting from that one?
Yes, regarding the next game, we will go back and then we'll talk about the next game. But when you see this game, we played a professional club, and we are even not, we are amateurs, and the players are still 18, 19 years old, and they will make mistakes like this, and this is the time to, for them to learn to. So that's it.
Thanks, Ravinesh.
Okay, so philosophical from Ravinesh Kumar, and he's quite right. He's got a team of youngsters.
The head. Those who think that everything, as we've mentioned, the commentary, Gori, that winning is everything right now, believe me, it's not. And this is the perfect platform for them to prepare.
Okay, so then confirmation then of the result that Buzai Teen have beaten Fiji under 20 by 7-1. That concludes our coverage of the OFC President's Cup. On behalf of my colleagues Indra Singh and Mr. Miles Davis, who was here earlier, we wish you a very good evening. And from me, Gordon Watson, good night, and we'll see you next time.